Welcome back to my channel. This is psychic medium Raymond Guzman, and this is your weekly horoscope forecast for the entire zodiac sign for the week of October 22nd through the 28th, 2018. If this is the first time that you're tuning into my channel or to this video, please go ahead and take some time to hit the red subscribe button on the bottom right hand corner of this video, as well as the notification bell icon, so that way you can be notified of any future videos that I do publish. Also, be sure to catch my show, Tea with Spirit. It airs every Monday at 5 p.m. Central Standard Time, 3 p.m. Pacific Time, 4 p.m. Mountain Time, and 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And basically, this is a show being compared to the psychic version of Dear Abby, which I give the tea, which is spiritual advice from spirit directly to people all around the world who submit one question to my email. You can email me at raymondguzman@hotmail.com. On the subject line of your email, just put Tea with Spirit. And then in the body of your email, go ahead and include a specific question that you would like some tea on, and an alias, because if your question is selected, I will be reading it on the air. And for confidentiality purposes, I won't give out your real name. So yeah, go ahead and submit those. Also, be sure to check out my new book. It's called Starseed Footsteps. It is available on my website if you want an autographed copy. If you don't want the autographed copy, you can also get it on Amazon or barnesandnoble.com. And it is a book about spirituality. I cover so many topics, everything from witchcraft to the occult to spirits to what happens to our souls when we die, twin flames, and I discuss lots more in there. So it's very excited. Pick up a copy of it. It's getting rave reviews. It's a really great, great book. So without further ado, let's get into the horoscopes for this week. Aries, this week is going to be a lot of different things going on. There's a lot of energy. There's a lot of deception around you, Aries. There's a lot of things that maybe you're not saying. When it comes into this week, there's a lot of secrets, things that you're holding on to right now. Maybe this could be around your next action, you know, your next step. But there's something that you are planning, something that you are making a move on, but you are very secretive right now, and you don't want to many people to know. For those of you that are in a relationship that is committed at some level, you would be experiencing, now this may not appeal, you know, or apply to everybody that is an Aries sign, because everybody's different. But for the most part, spirit is saying that there is a certain level of heartache. Your relationship is not as perfect as you make it seem on social media, or you make it seem to your friends. Those are facades that you're putting on right now. Spirit is saying that the relationship is suffering, that there is some difficulties around a relationship that you'd be having right now. There is heartache on the horizon. This could be a third party situation, feelings that you're maybe developing for another person. But again, this goes back to the secrets that you're holding on to, and you don't want to hurt your partner because you do love them genuinely, but there's feelings that you are developing for someone else. And vice versa, this could be your partner, you know, going through this, or them subconsciously at a soul level knowing or feeling like this is something that's going on with you, but you can't express it right now. So there's a lot of going back and forth in your mind. There's a lot of you trying to connect to spirit and really kind of understand what your emotions are. You know, why are you feeling this way? What is going on with this? It's very confusing at some level for some of you out there. For those of you that are single, this wouldn't obviously apply to you. So for those of you that are single, and those of you that may be in a relationship as well, there's a lot of other focus this week on money. There could be, you know, future plans, planning right now, and aligning with a female energy. A lot of you Aries could be aligning with someone who is good at what they do. This would be like a female energy, and there's a lot of planning and money and things like that that are coming to the forefront. So although you are not where you want to be ideally, you know, in your life, a lot of you are working towards these goals. You're going towards it, and you're being, even though you can't feel it, or sometimes you may not feel like, you know, you're in the right career path, or that you're getting the progression that you need in your career. Spirit is basically saying you need to be patient. Everything happens with hard work, dedication, and perseverance, and that it's going to be happening. But you know, right now it's all about, you know, laying the groundwork and continue to not give up and work. Focus on that. A lot of you this week could also be very sensitive. People could be triggering you, pushing your buttons. They could be testing you. There's this feeling like you feel like you're being judged by other people. You're being ridiculed, or you're being attacked personally by other people. And it doesn't, you know, the energy doesn't feel good. It feels very stagnant and very oppressive at some times this week. So if you are in that kind of predicament, you just need to refocus yourself and ask yourself, you know, why these people that are attacking you, it's a projection of their own insecurities and their own, you know, negativity, their own drama going on in their life. It's not anything to do with you, so don't take it personally. And that's what Spirit is wanting to get across this week for you, Aries. All right, for Taurus this week, Taurus, you Taurians out there, a lot of you are going to be experiencing a lot of movement. There's a lot of things that are going on right now in your life that you're not maybe sharing with everyone. You don't like to really, you know, be very emotional or be connected to that. But in your, you know, in your loneliest hour, in the time that you are by yourself and not, you know, really focusing on work or anything else, you do tend to get into your thoughts, into your emotions. Your health may be also suffering as a result, because you have a lot of this energy that has been built up in you, and you may have some anger towards, or frustration towards people that have hurt you. And so a lot of these emotions are evoked. But you need to release that to the higher power and get rid of that. Purge yourself of these emotions when they do set in, and transmute that into something positive, because again, that can create some major health issues for you if you're not careful with that. There's also this sense of feeling that you are maybe losing out on a money opportunity. Maybe there was a job offer and you didn't take it, or there's something that around you that is centered around money this week. And again, this may not apply to every single Taurian out there, but for those of you that are the sign of Taurus, you know, I'm seeing this week that there could be something that you're feeling like you're losing out on an opportunity, but really it's the universe rerouting you. So even though you may, sometimes we may want something and want it so bad and think it's good for us, it really isn't. So there's a lot right now where you may be turning more to your spiritual guides, needing to go within and ask yourself these questions and turn to your faith a little bit more. It may seem like this last couple of weeks you kind of deviated away from that, from Spirit, from your connection to Spirit, and mainly have been focusing more on, you know, your family and other things in your life that take precedence. But there's a lot of spiritual things on the spiritual level that is occurring, and it feels very fulfilling. This could be a lot of you out there that are single, starting a new relationship, and you know, someone trying to offer you, you know, their love, and it's very peaceful, and it comes out very, very emotional this week for you, for a lot of you. And also there would be other opportunities that are coming up around money. So those of you that may have, like I said, gone or experienced some kind of loss, financial loss, there's going to be a lot to gain by the end of the week and going into, you know, the next couple of weeks. It's, you know, it's like a little roller coaster through this Venus retrograde, since it doesn't end till November 16th or whatnot. So you just hang in there and be positive, and know that, you know, everything's going to get better. It's going to require, like I said, some work on your part and some going in with deep within to your spiritual self. But if you do that, everything will make sense to you and be more logical than, you know, you trying to interpret it like right now. It may not make any sense right now, but it will. So that was your horoscope for this week for Taurus. Gemini, this week for you, Gemini, there's a lot of going on around your love life. For those of you that are single, or for those of you that are in a relationship, there's a lot of talk about twin flame, your twin flame, and about having that relationship. If you have been a little distant from your twin flame, perhaps you're not together, or there with someone else, you know, whatever the situation is, there's a lot of focus between a you as a Gemini and your partner, whoever you're with, whether you're in a relationship or you're not, but you know who your twin flame is. There's a lot of focus around soulmates, twin flames this week, and union. There's a lot of happiness. So those of you that maybe are separated or not communicating, there will be a lot of communication that's more intense this week. A lot more happy vibes that come in as a result of the communication, because we are the sign of communication as Gemini. And so there's a lot of positivity that surrounds us this week with communication and just being in contact with your partner and feeling that love overall. As you get later into the week, there's going to be a lot more focus on money, on your financial situation. You could be feeling like, your partner is giving a little bit to another person and giving a little bit to you, especially for those of you that would be with a partner that has an ex or children from an ex marriage or relationship. You could be feeling like you're getting, a little bit of the attention, but the other person is also getting a little bit of attention. This can create some jealousy. It can create some emotions that, regardless if you'd like to admit it or not, they're there on the surface and it can bother you. Well, the main message here from Spirit is to release those kind of feelings and just trust your partner, because when you don't trust them, there could be these insecurities that emerge that just lead to bickering and, accusations and things that are low-level vibrations that you really don't need right now. But your partner will be reminding you later this week how much you are loved. At the same time, there is someone in your midst that could be feeling like they are defeated. It is like a very gloomy moment this week for someone. And I get this would be a male energy. So those of you that are females that are, have a male in your life, there's something that he is going through. And for those of you that are male that may have a male in your life, whether this is a friend, a partner, a husband, someone, there's something going on around their emotions and them not being able to fully vocalize this. This could be concerns about their work, concerns about their, their family, that they're not, doing good. There's a lot of pressure they're putting on themselves and a lot of self-reflection, but through it, it feels like the dark night of the soul, where they're going through this transformation almost, and they're going to come out of it okay. And rise from it, in a spectacular manner. But while they go through the motion of this, it is going to seem very chaotic, very depressing, so to speak. But karma's at play here. So whatever they are going through, it is karmic in nature, and they have to go through this right now to get stronger and really like have that wake up call that, there is something in their life they need to change, something they need to accept, something they need to do. And it may not make any sense in the moment to them why they're having to go through this, but in time it will make more sense to them. But the main message here is for them to just be, there for them, give them consolation if needed, but also give them space, because a lot of them may feel like they are almost like being smothered by us Gemini. So if you are going through this situation right now with someone in your life, just give them time and give them space. That's the main message for Gemini for this week. Cancer, this week for you, Cancer, there's a lot of movement around relationships and love life. Your love life is the highlight this week. There's a lot of happiness, a lot of kind of thinking about the future with your partner. There's just a lot that's being highlighted around your love life and coming together. There's also this feeling that you are kind of needing to reevaluate something in your life that is not making you happy. It's like you have every other thing in your life going well for you, but when it comes to your emotions and it comes to your love life, in some ways, you don't feel ultimate fulfillment. It's almost like you are sitting there and you're waiting for something to fill you up or make you feel fulfilled from within. So Spirit is basically saying just to be patient, that is coming. You can't force it. And someone is going to be fighting for you. They are going to be cutting something out of their life. So if you're like in a third party situation, or you're waiting for your your partner or potential mate to make a decision and kind of show more, profess more of their love for you, or condition, you know, or focus more on building a family life with you. That is going to happen. There is going to be that, you know, focus this week on family and happy times. So it's all going to be about patience. Right now you could be feeling a little impatient. There's also some celebration around money. So this could be you getting a promotion or recently gotten a promotion, you know, or having this money and now you're thinking of how to spend it. Just be cautious when it comes to spending. You want to save your money as much as you can. And then you can, you know, use that later on whenever you feel a little bit more of a safety net or security. But right now it shouldn't be a week for you to kind of like waste $300 or $400 on a costume for Halloween, or, you know, buy a Corvette, kind of, you know, unless you really have, you know, ironed out your finances and have made sure that you can, you know, do this. It would be best for you to kind of like curve any tendencies right now to spend for large items, because there could be other things that come up here shortly as the year is not over with, and you may need that, those funds or that money. So this is the horoscope for this week for Cancer. Leo, this week for you, Leo, there is a lot of focus right now between two decisions, two paths, two choices. This week, it's all about you making a decision. This has been going on for quite some time. This is very much revolving around your family, children, your love life. There's, you know, where your home, your circle of your home is. Basically, this is being highlighted in this key area. There's a lot of debate whether, you know, you've been sitting with a lot of ideas, a lot of, you know, thinking deeply within yourself, spending some time to ask the universe, you know, why am I going through all this right now in my life? Why hasn't it gotten better? There's this feeling of almost like you almost feel almost defeated. You feel like, you know, that there is no hope, that nothing is going to change. This is a lot of mirroring. This is a lot of you getting a projection from your shadow self. Your shadow self is coming out and emerging, and it's building and it's projecting a lot of the negativity. We all have a duality. We have a shadow self and a light self. But your light self is fighting the shadow self, and it's, you know, it's like one, it's like you have two angels. You have the devil and you have the angel on your shoulders. And, you know, the devil is telling you, you know, you're not going to amount to anything. This is, you know, you're a loser. This is going on. And I'm just using this as a kind of like an example. And on the other shoulder, you have your angel, and your angel is telling you, you know, you're loved. You are beautiful. You are handsome. You are worthy. Everything's going to be okay. But with everything that's going on this week around your love life and your, you know, your family, you know, if you had an ex, all of this energy, it seems like you tend to, you know, feed more or believe more the shadow self, the devil, you know, on the right shoulder instead of the angel that's on your left shoulder. So you just need to really just not pay attention to all those negative self thinking. This is a process. It's not something where you just snap your fingers and, you know, it's fixed and it resolved and we're done with it. It is a lot. It requires a lot of self-work, a lot of self-love, you know, writing mantras, having them on sticky notes everywhere, reading them constantly throughout the day, believing in it. A lot of you have lost some belief in your spirituality, even though you may, you know, talk about it to your friends, and you may be very adamant that you're very spiritual and that you believe, you know, you believe and believe. That's not necessarily the case of what spirit is presenting this week for you. They know a little bit more about what's going on in your situation. So it feels like there is some movement. You are moving past this and you are trying to take charge and be very responsible about the situation. But at the same time, you don't want to be alone. A lot of you that would be single right now don't want to be alone. You want someone already in your life. And you may be wanting that because you see your ex, or you see, you know, someone that used to be in your life with someone else and you feel like they're happy, you know, that they're living their life and you're still stuck in this situation. But again, you have to stop comparing yourself to that person. Not all that glitters is gold. Just because someone seems happy or they parade on social media or they post all these things, you know, means that they're happy. A lot of people are very good actors. A lot of people are very good at projecting and putting facades and wearing masks. And so this is something that you need to really ask yourself, you know, why are you feeling this way? Why are you allowing yourself to be unhappy when you have everything at your fingertips? You are magical. You need to reclaim that power. So this is a very important message for you this week, for a lot of you Leos out there, is to know that you're the king of the jungle. You're majestic. You have the power. You need to tap into the higher power and you need to surrender and give it up and let it go. Don't be, you know, going over and beating yourself up over and over with the same thoughts and self-negative talk. You know, it's not good. It's not a high vibration. So later in the week, going into the weekend, there could be a party that you'd be attending. There could be some celebrations for Halloween. But the energy seems to shift completely from the negativity that starts off the week into something positive. So it's a good week to be a Leo. So this is the horoscope for Leo for this week. Virgo, this week for you, Virgo, it is going to be a week in which you are feeling trapped. That's the essential essence of this week. You feel trapped in a situation. You feel like you are hurt. There's a lot of pain. There's a lot of fights. There's a lot of things that are not just happening this week. They've been happening for the last couple of weeks for some of you out there. This seems like, you know, you're almost like fighting for something that you want. But there's so many obstacles and so many challenges. People are challenging you. Family is questioning you. There's people that are not, you know, don't have your best interests at hand. It feels like you are, you know, very much at the end of it and you don't know how to get out of the situation, pull yourself out. But there is hope. It is going to be a process, and what I'm seeing here for you is that Spirit is saying that there's going to be a lot more focus on your work. So a lot of you that may be feeling trapped, this could be actually talking about, you know, being trapped in a job, in a situation where you don't feel happy and you want to break free from it, but you just don't know how. But you're going to continue to work hard and diligent. And through that, you're going to be finding a lot of strength. A lot of you could be asking, you know, why am I going through these hardships? Why am I going and feeling this way for so long? It's because there's a life lesson here. There's always a lesson behind every hardship that we go through. And for you, it is going to be about learning how strong you are. A lot of you have maybe have forgotten, you know, how strong your spirit is, how strong your soul is. And so Spirit is reminding you that you are very strong and that you have what it takes to come ahead and get out of this stagnation that you're feeling. So they want you to kind of, you know, just really go with the flow, be happy, be yourself. Don't focus too much on the negative, because everything that you want is coming to you. For those of you that are single, there could be a male in your life or a female. There is an offer to you, someone professing their affection or their love for you. And it could be that you've already, you know, began a relationship, but it's being taken to the next level here. And there's just a lot of more happiness. There could also be that this person is going to spoil you or buy you something, you know, even though you don't need them to buy you anything. But it could be like a gesture, something that they want to surprise you with. Whatever it is, Spirit is saying to accept it, not don't fight it. You know, be willing to accept. There's nothing wrong in accepting gifts or accepting something from someone who loves you unconditionally. But a lot of you may be struggling with, you know, accepting, because you were probably raised in a way where, you know, you were taught that, you know, you need to work for your things and not have people hand them out to you for, you know, and you may be feeling like you're feeling pity, or there's some other kind of objective, or, you know, something, an ulterior motive that they have and the reason why they're giving you something. But that's not the case. You need to think positive and just think that if they're giving to you or showing you or wanting to express their love for you, it is genuine. And that's the energy that spirit wants for you to you know, really understand this week. So this is the horoscope for the sign of Virgo for this week. All right, Libra, this week for you, Libra, there's a lot of feelings that you are now shifting into a good, positive area in your life. There's a lot of you out there that would be feeling, you know, good vibrations around your, you know, your self-work, your home space. A lot of you that are into Wicca or into magic, there is a lot of power and resurgence that is happening this week with the veil being so thin, the month of October. There's a lot of magic in the air. There's a lot of risk taking. You're feeling spontaneous. You're feeling, a lot of you out there that are Libras are feeling very, you know, in a good place right now. Even though financially you may be struggling a little bit or have some uncertainties in that area, a lot of you know that you are going to be provided for regardless. And there's this, like I said, this feeling of, you know, you're taking a risk, maybe going into a new job, you know, starting a new relationship, or just overall in your way of thinking or the way that you communicate with people. You're just being yourself, being very open and very, very much true to who you are. And you don't mean any harm to anyone at all. There could be a battle that you've been going through at your workplace or with your family for quite some time, and you just don't understand why, you know, you are in this position, but you do have the upper hand. Spirit is basically saying that you will defeat all this negativity and these obstacles that have been presenting themselves in your life path, and you just don't know why. And later in the week, there is going to be some focus between you and your love. So those of you that are in a relationship or you know, thinking about someone that you used to be with, there's a lot of focus and kind of like going in and really kind of focusing on the dark parts of that life that you shared together with that person in healing. There's a lot of healing that is taking place. And through the eyes of a healer, you're able to kind of really release a lot of this and really just, you know, focus more on the positive things. So you're cutting through a lot of the unnecessary energies that once, you know, kind of had you strapped down or shackled to a negative space in your life or a negative time or darker time. And you basically are releasing all of this and moving very much ahead towards your goals. So a lot of you will see a lot of work being accomplished this week. There's a lot of focus, a lot of mental clarity, and there's a higher connection to spirit and to the higher power. Like I said, the veils between the worlds of the living and the dead are very, very thin this week. So a lot of you that would be, you know, wanting to perhaps, you know, turn more to your spiritual side, you could be noticing your third eye goes off, or people are responding to you in this magical way where they see, you know, your light, they see your beauty, they see your power, and it's being honored and being basically them, you know, acknowledging that they see who you are as a person and that you are beautiful. But a lot of you out there may not see that yourself, and you need to kind of start looking at yourself in that way. It's not shallow. It's not full of, it's not an egotistical thing to love yourself and to love yourself unconditionally and put yourself first before anybody else. And that's something that you haven't been doing. So spirit wants to remind you, you know, take yourself out to go get your hair done, go and buy a new pair of shoes, go and get a new wardrobe, you know, get a mani or a pedi done. These are things about self-care and pampering yourself and loving yourself unconditionally. And there's nothing wrong with that. So that's your horoscope for this week for the sign of Libra. All right, for the sign of Scorpio this week, for the Scorpios out there, there's a lot going on right now about your life in general. A lot of you have been feeling restrained, have been feeling like you didn't have a clear sense of direction, but you're just going to, you know, go with it. This is the idea this week behind the energy. Spirit is wanting you to kind of let go, just go with it. A lot of you are standing very solidly financially. You're in a good position. This may not apply to every Scorpio, but a lot of you know how to save money and how to really treasure it. And now you could be sitting on a little nest egg that you have saved. And, you know, there may be some things that you want to do this week that kind of to pamper yourself or just to have fun, you know, and get out of the regular situation. But you know, at a certain point, you're still kind of like thinking, you know, do I really want to waste my money? Do I really want to do this? You know, do I really want to do all of this? And spirit is basically saying, yes, you need to do it. You need to really kind of think outside of the box and go with it. So, a lot of you that are single out there, you won't be single for long. This is a week in which a lot of you out there could be feeling this, a lot of you Scorpios could be feeling a lot more sexual energy that is going, you know, either with you, your twin flame, your soulmate. There's a lot of sexual energy that is being exchanged. These could be in the form of thoughts, dreams, feelings. You could be feeling your, you know, your soulmate, even though you're not physically with them, and they're at work or they are, you know, in another state. There's a lot of this communication that is taking place this week, and it's only going to get intense going into the weekend. As you get into the weekend, a lot of you out there would be more kind of alone. Some of you may be in parties, but for the most part, even if you're in a party, you know, or somewhere, your mind is going to be somewhere else. It's not going to be in that event or in that party or in that celebration. Sure, you may laugh and you may be talking to people and you may be doing this and that, but ultimately your spirit is somewhere else and it's thinking about, you know, your partner. It's thinking about your love life. There's a lot with the Venus retrograde. There's a lot of focus around love life for Scorpios and, you know, thinking about, you know, where you are right now, and where you want to be in the next couple of months going into 2019. So, this is going to be a very auspicious time, a very magical time. A lot of you would be tapping into your magical side, as well, and divination, different forms of it. Your dreams could be a little bit more intense than normal this week, again, because the worlds of the living and the dead, the veils are very thin. And so there's a lot of intensity in communication with the spirit world. So, this is the energy for and the forecast for Scorpio for this week. All right, this is going to be the horoscope for Sagittarius. This week for you, Sagittarius, it is going to be a week in which you're feeling like someone is being deceitful. There's a lot of lies surrounding you. This could be in the form of a male energy that is lying to you, that is trying to take something from you. At the same time, there is a lot of communication between you and another person. And this could be like you coming out of a relationship with some walls around your heart, but somebody else is wanting to come into your life now. And you're just sitting there and you're like, you know, confronting them and really more defensive than anything. You're ready for, you know, for the negative, and you're because that's all that you've been shown in your relationships lately. So a lot of you could be very defensive and thinking, you know, should I even accept new love? Am I even ready for it? And spirit is basically saying that you are, rather, regardless if this is a love situation or just more of a friendship. They are saying that it is time for you to kind of release a lot of these worries. The universe is working with you, Mother Gaia, and all the energy of the universe is working for you, and they want to see you happy. So it is your time to kind of, you know, release all these fears, all of these negative thinking or negativity that you have in your life, cutting out people that are negative from your life that influence you, that make you believe that you're not worthy of being happy. And so with that, you are going to be finding that you are more powerful than you think. There is going to be a lot more of you feeling more spiritual, more connected to what you're wanting, and kind of seeing the final outcome of all of this around your life. It is coming to a culmination to a certain point where you're feeling like, you know, everything is making more sense. Whereas the last couple of weeks may have been confusing to you, or you could have felt like certain things didn't make sense at all. This is going to be a time in which now you are going to be feeling like things are all making sense. Everything is working together in some kind of way at the divine level. So, this is a horoscope for the sign of Sagittarius for this week. Capricorn, this week for you, Capricorn, it is going to be a week in which you need to rest. I know there's a lot of things going on for those of you that have kids or have families. You could be having Halloween, you know, parties to go to, making costumes, baking cupcakes or cookies or you know, picking up things. You know, there's a lot of movement and energy this week that's going to have you restless. If you're going to feel very tired this week energetically, and you need to take some time out for yourself, you know, periodically, to get some relaxation. A lot of you also could be feeling like you're in a situation where there's two people, two men that you are not sure of, you know, whether you're a female or a male. There's two males or that are around you, and you could be deciding, you know, what your heart is wanting. This is more around your love life. You could be deciding, you know, do I want to go with this person that has money, or do I want to go with someone who's more, you know, more spiritual in nature and more passionate and shows more of their love, and they don't need, you know, money to kind of show off. And then you have the person that's with the money, very much ego driven, egocentric, and they want, you know, power. That's their main thing, and they may judge other people harshly. So a lot of you may be in that situation with, you know, you're stuck in the middle and you're having to decide, and you never thought that you would be in this position. So if you are in that position, Spirit is basically asking you to kind of reassess, you know, your current situation, what, you know, what you're feeling, your thoughts, and really make a decision as to what is best for you. No one can make that decision but yourself. So a lot of you may be seeking out psychic readings this week. A lot of you could be getting some insight from a spiritual advisor. There's a lot of confusion that surrounds you. Even though you may, you know, be able to think about it on a deeper level, you may need some eyes or ears from the outside to kind of guide you. You know, having discussions with your friends is good. That's another way that you could go as well. But it's all going to be up to you. But there is definitely a lot of focus around your life right now and two people. And again, this may not apply to every Capricorn out there, but that's the energy that comes in this week. There's a lot of choices and decisions in your life that you're needing to make specifically around your love life. And once you're able to get that clarity and get that off your, you know, your chest, you're going to feel a lot better about, you know, choosing the right person for you, and knowing that ultimately there's no mistakes in this life. Nothing is coincidence. Nothing's by chance. Anyone that, you know, that is in our life is there for a reason. And that's kind of the energy this week for the sign of Capricorn. Aquarius, this week for you, Aquarius, it's very interesting. It starts off the week, your week starts off in a way where you are thinking about two different decisions, two different choices. You're kind of juggling two different ideas. This could be around your professional world or even in your personal love life. There's two different things or two different people, two different choices that you're having to really weigh your options, and you're going back and forth in almost this this infinity type of situation, like the sign of the number eight, where it kind of flows back and forth. This is the kind of energy that comes around, and there's a lot of focus around you know, your emotions, what you're feeling. A lot of you could be working with someone or meeting up with a female friend who you trust, that could be giving you a lot more clarity this week about your feelings and things that you've experienced over the weekend, things that, you know, that you are now, you know, really tapping into. But still there's this level of fear that you're having, and it feels like you're, you know, you're having to walk away from a situation, but it doesn't make you happy. That's what the energy is showing. There's a lot of you walking away, and going, you know, past you finally are pushing through the limitations or obstacles that have been created in the past. And a lot of this is being done in an objective manner, in a very spiritual way. But at the same time, you feel like, you know, there is this level of darkness that still surrounds you, and you're tired, and a lot of you are just defeated, even though you may, you know, not show it all the time on the outside. On the inside, a lot of you just feel tired. You're tired of, you know, all the hard work. You're tired of, you know, having to deal with difficult people. But there is a turning point. There is a lot of positivity in this. You could be asking yourself, why am I having to go through this? Why am I having to feel this way and feel like, you know, I don't have any time for myself? It's all about work, or it's all about, you know, family. There's a lot of things that you're suppressing right now that you need to really kind of turn to. A lot of you could be having some healing that needs to take place in your family, but you've been ignoring them, or you have been wanting to go away from it. Spirit is basically saying that you need to revisit this. There are some conversations that you need to have. You need to let go of whatever pain that has been caused in your childhood or in your family life. A lot of this is affecting a lot of you Aquarians out there. And with the Venus retrograde, this is something that is magnified this week. And although there may be festivities and there may be parties and celebrations, in the back corner of your mind, even though you're present and you are drinking or you're having fun and you're, you know, having conversations and listening to music, at the core of your heart and the core at the core of your mind, there is these thoughts that you are not happy. Your life is not happy, even though you've gotten to that point where you kind of have made yourself believe that you're happy. You're not happy. There is a void still there. And so Spirit is basically saying that you are going to be experiencing this on a deeper level, because Spirit wants you to purify that part of yourself. They want you to fight it. They want you to continue to fight. You're not done fighting. You know, you need to continue to make some choices that are going to be very painful to you. These are choices that are not easy. But through these choices, you are going to come out of it in a positive and upbeat manner, and you're going to walk into the light. There is going to be someone that brings you the light. They are the light. And even though you may be surrounded by someone that's dark, someone who puts on facades, someone or a group of people that are rooted in darkness, you are going to come out of this in a very, very positive way. But there is going to be a healer, someone that comes into your life, very powerful, that is going to be bringing that healing over the next couple of months. But you have to surrender yourself to the higher power. That's the only thing. There's a lot of resistance for a lot of you Aquarians out there, knowing that there is change that needs to be doing, and you're trying to turn to different avenues, to different ways to get to that light, to release that fear that you still have. But even though you turn to all of this, it's just like band-aids that you're putting on your wounds. But there is going to be a turnaround. There is going to be some positivity coming into your life, and you just need to be very aware of that. So this was the horoscope for this week for the sign of Aquarius. Pisces, this week for you Pisces, there's a lot of focus around magic. A lot of you could be turning to Wicca or to magic. There's a lot of you that is trying to find the balance. You're trying to find your way. A lot of you are trying to become more spiritual in nature. You're trying to discover your gifts, discover who you are. And with the energy and the veils being so thin between the worlds of the living and the dead this week, and the veils, there's a lot of communication with Spirit. But at the same time, there could be some arguments that are erupting in a relationship. There could be some disagreements. There could be some things that are coming up very soon that are, you know, kind of leading to you feeling maybe like, you know, you did something wrong. And it's not about you doing anything wrong, but really about maybe the other person and you, you know, kind of noticing that there are differences, but you're trying to hide that, you know, on the surface, or really not focus on it. A lot of you could be thinking, you know, well, everything seems okay on the outside, and sure, my partner is laughing or smiling, but on the inside, I know something is wrong. And ultimately, I know that something is wrong within me as well, that I don't feel this this healing and this communication. But, you know, on the outside, I'm trying to hide it so that my friends and people around me won't see it or know what I'm really thinking. So, you know, there's a lot of masks that are being weared right now that people are wearing. And you may be wearing a mask yourself. And so Spirit is asking you to kind of like take off the mask, to really strip down to the core of who you are and be authentic in everything that you do. With that, you are going to find a lot of truth, and you're going to be stepping more into the light, and you're going to be able to help other people with their problems. It's not that you are doing this on purpose or intentionally, but some of you may just be fearful of, you know, being judged, and you're trying to fit in. You're trying to be like the other person that maybe you're with, or you may be trying to be the person that the other person that you're with, you may feel like that's what they want you to be like. And you need to just be yourself and remind yourself of who you are, essentially, and not try to, you know, be someone else or try to be molded by this person that you're with, or whoever, you know, or the friends that you carry. A lot of the friends that you carry seem to carry more of a dark vibration. And so there's a lot of cutting out that you need to do from that, to kind of step into the light. There could also be moments where you feel like you're judging other people this week, without even realizing it. You know, you need to catch yourself, things that you're saying, things that you're doing. You know, you could be very judgmental about how someone dresses, how they look, or because they don't have money. You know, you may be judging them and not realizing that you're doing this. And when you do this, it brings your vibration down to a lower level. So these are things that you need to kind of catch yourself this week. Again, it's very easy, especially with the magic that's going on this week, the intensity of the of this time period of, you know, October, it's very easy to get drawn into that kind of energy. So kind of reevaluate the people that you're hanging around with. Reevaluate. There is this level of maturity that needs to be coming more to the forefront. It's good to connect to your inner child and to have that fun vibe and that fun energy. But if it's coming at the expense of making fun of someone or hurting someone else, whether these are more internal thoughts or you know, talking to your best friends about it, just be careful, because there could be something that comes around, like that saying that what goes around comes around. That could be happening. So again, this is not to create any kind of fear, but to create an awareness to maybe the darker side of yourself that you're not aware of, and that you're maybe feeding a little bit more than stepping more into the light side. So these are just things that Spirit is bringing to the forefront for this week. So this is a horoscope for the sign of Pisces. So I want to thank everyone for tuning in. If you did like this video, please be sure to give it a thumbs up. Also, be sure to follow me on Facebook and Instagram. And if you would like to set up a private reading with me, you can go to my website. That's www.raymondguzman.net/shop. Blessings and love and light. Have an amazing week.